Oh my goodness, it's a robot dog. Literally. I mean, strange. This is a robot dog. It's a dog robot. This robot acts like a dog, moves on its own like a dog. It's kind of cool. This is a robot that cleans floors. Maybe you've seen one of these before, or maybe there's one in your house. Robots are pretty interesting because they move on their own, but they aren't alive. They aren't living, which has me thinking, okay, what makes something alive? How do we know the difference between living and non-living things? Well, there are a few things to think about when we try to figure out if something is a living or a non-living thing. And the first thing to think about is water. That's right, water. Hang on, what does water have to do with living and non-living things? Why are we thinking about water? There's a simple reason why. You see, all living things need water. All living things need water. Did you like my robot voice? For example, grass needs water. Like all plants, grass is a living thing and needs water to survive. This boy is giving the grass the water it needs and is having fun at the same time. Here's another example. Dogs need water. Like all animals, dogs are living things and need water to survive. Cute dog. Yeah, I don't see a robot dog drinking water. Interesting. It seems our robot friend is a non-living thing. Didn't pass the water test. The next thing we want to think about when figuring out if something is living or non-living is how or if it changes over time. That's because all living things develop and grow. All living things develop and grow just like with this plant. It develops from a tiny little sapling, a little baby plant, into a mature plant. You can see how it grows. It gets bigger and stronger. Like all living things, this plant develops and grows over time. Watch this plant grow. It's so awesome. Plants really are living things. Now, it doesn't happen this fast. This is sped up so we can see it grow, but it's so cool. Here, we can see elephants of different sizes. Like all living things, elephants grow. Little elephants grow up to be big elephants. Living things grow. The final thing we want to think about when we're trying to figure out if something is living or non-living is if it needs food. Remember how living things grow? Well, living things need food to do that growing. All living things need food. If you've watched many Homeschool Pop videos, you know how much I love carrots. I think of carrots when I think of food. Here's a picture of the sun. Why do you think the sun is pictured when we talk about food? Do you know? Plants use sunlight to make their own food. Wow. It's called photosynthesis. Can you say that with me? Photosynthesis. Yeah, can we say it like a robot? Photosynthesis. Photosynthesis is how plants use sunlight to make their own food. They literally make their own food using sunlight. So for us, food looks very different than it does for plants. Plants make their own food using sunlight, and that's called photosynthesis. Food is different for another type of living thing called fungi. Fungi. Mushrooms are a type of fungi. Mold is a type of fungi. Mold. Fungi are living things. They need water, they grow, and they need food. But they have a strange way of getting that food. You see, fungi absorb their food. They don't eat like we do or make their own food like plants do. They just absorb it. Wouldn't it be weird if we absorbed food like fungi do? That would be strange. That would be very, very strange. Hey, let's go over the clues again. The clues to figure out if something is a living or non-living thing. First, living things need water. Water. Second, Living things grow. They go from being tiny to full grown. They develop over time. Third, living things need food. We talked about how living things can have different ways of getting that food, either through eating like we do, using sunlight to make food like plants do, or absorbing food like fungi. But all living things need food. All right, I think it's time to practice using these clues. Okay. Is this bird living or non-living? Is this bird living or non-living? Yeah, living. We know this bird is living instead of non-living because this bird needs water, this bird grows, and this bird needs food. Great. Let's try this one next. Is this balloon living or non-living? Is this balloon living or non-living? Yeah, non-living. While the balloon grows and gets bigger when you blow it up with air, it doesn't need water to survive and it doesn't need food. You need all three clues for something to be a living thing. A balloon is a non-living thing. Awesome job. What about this palm tree? Is this a living or non-living thing? Living. Trees, just like other plants, need water, grow, and need food. Awesome job. Here's our last one. Is this globe living or non-living? Is this globe living or non-living? Yeah, non-living. It doesn't need water to survive, it doesn't grow, and it doesn't need food. A globe is a non-living thing. If something needs water, grows, and needs food, it's living. Yeah, it's a living thing. If something needs water, grows, and needs food, it's living. Yeah, it's a living thing. I think you're ready. You know all the clues. Now you can explain exactly how this robot dog is not a living thing, even though it moves on its own. It doesn't pass the test, but mold does. Wow, I'm sorry. That's weird. It's weird that mold is a living thing. I don't like that. Not one bit. I don't like it. You watched this video to the end, which is so cool. Real quick, as we wrap this up, if you have not subscribed to our channel, if you'll take a moment to do that, we have so many learning videos and we want you to be in the loop with new uploads. So click subscribe if that sounds like a blast. We hope you had a fun time. Thank you for watching. We want to give a massive thank you to our patrons. You can learn how to support us and get Homeschool Pop tattoos, so fashionable, on our website, homeschoolpop.com, or by clicking the link below this video. That would be really cool. You know you're awesome. We know you're awesome. And we're excited to see you on the next learning video.